Have you seen The Mask? No, not that Jim Carrey movie where he like takes his face off and reveals he's actually been a Green Goblin this whole time. No. This is the lesser known but seriously impressive 3D hallucinogenic trip to hell, 1961's The Mask. The Mask's story starts off with a man murdering his lover, but that doesn't seem to be the biggest thing on his mind. No, he's more worried about what's on his head, on his face instead. The mask. This crazy skull-looking mask apparently causes whoever to wear it to see a world of pain, misery, and flaming skeletons. These visions drive the wearer to become a killer, either of those around them or of themselves. The man sends the mask off before offing himself, and the mask arrives in the hands of a doctor. The doctor, a psychiatrist of sorts, is tempted by some strange voice that says, "Put the mask on now." So he does so. And though he can take the mask off, he can't take off the effect it has on his mind. Maybe just one more peek into the world of the mask will be all he needs. You know those haunted house carnival attractions? That's what The Mask truly is as a movie. A long wait in line to enter into a world of smoke, mirrors, skeletons, strange sights, and potentially, the best case for horror, frightening stuff. There's about 25 minutes of what I would call nothing interesting before The Mask gets to its point. And when it does, it's amazing. And it has to do with putting on the mask. Whoever puts on the mask enters a strange world of death, which comes to unlife on the screen thanks to the use of 3D imagery, achieved here by James B. Gordon, who worked on effects for some popular movies of the 50s and 60s that you've probably heard of. Not only are the zombies and skeletons popping off the screen in this world, the subjects of the dreams are way ahead of what was the standard for scary stuff in the early 1960s. There's gnarly gore, burned bodies wearing the mask and blowing out flames, popped out eyeballs, incredibly detailed Mayan-like temple sets with strange figures teleporting in and out or running amongst the fog. It's weird. These visions are endlessly fascinating to watch and even a bit disturbing by today's standards. The people who made this must have done some sort of LSD to come up with the imagery that's in this movie. They had to have. There's no way they didn't. Accompanying the visuals is a truly eerie, primordial electronic music soundtrack done with composition by Louis Applebaum and the electronic wizardry of Myron Schaeffer. The soundtrack is as alien and fascinating as what the mask makes people see, believe it or not, to the point that people have actually ripped the music from the movie just so they could listen to it. I say play it at Halloween displays and really give those kids something to nightmare on. It's effective stuff. That said, these fantastic visuals are brief. We're given three of these amazing scenes in this phantasmagoric hellscape. The rest of the movie is planted firmly in boring old black and white reality, where people spend every moment talking, talking, talking about the mask. While it is well shot and it has interesting filming angles, largely the real world isn't interesting. And the talks that they have in the real world don't reveal anything interesting or of importance about what the mask is, what the lore of the mask is, really anything. The story is a cop trying to find the mask, a lady wondering what the mask is doing to her husband, and trying to get the mask away from him while also lying to the police about what her husband's doing with the mask, strangely. I don't know why she would try to get the mask away from him, then the guy gets it and she stops caring apparently, and then lies to the police about what's going on. It doesn't make any sense. Or maybe it's the doctor who really, really wants to put the mask on and trip his almighty balls off. Those parts of the normal world are pretty cool because it again has to do with the mask and actually wearing it. That said, I really enjoyed The Mask. It was apparently the first Canadian movie to be imported into America since the 1920s, which is crazy. If it was going to be any movie, why not this one, I guess? I did expect it to be a William Castle type affair, a movie that's really just scenes based around delivering audiences into a gag based on sight or sound or some other gag. Indeed, just like 13 Ghosts, the movie where you can see the ghost wearing 3D glasses, The Mask opens up with a professor telling the audience how to wear our own 3D glasses/mask in the theater whenever some weird stuff's about to go down on the screen. There were some cool green glasses, kind of a half mask, made for the release of the movie. In this case, Anaglyph 3D glasses will work, even today, with the mask. I got some online for cheap, they're not hard to find, and the effect still works. Sometimes these movies with 3D effects really strain a movie's sense of reality. The movies have to try and walk a thin line of delivering the 3D effects, but also not being too weird and doing too much in the 3D realm. It becomes weird after a certain point. Say for instance in these other movies, you'll see stuff like a character yo-yoing directly into a camera so the yo-yo looks like it's coming out into the audience. That happened in Friday the 13th Part 3, and it totally takes you out of the movie. Or in another horror film, someone throwing a frisbee right at the camera, which is what happened in Amityville 3D. It's very silly. And it looks really silly because technically you can watch those films without glasses as you're watching just normal scenes in a movie, but it doesn't really work because they keep doing weird stuff like throwing things at the screen. It takes you out of it totally. So you kind of have to watch it in 3D to get the real effect. Well, those problems don't exist for the mask. The creators worked the 3D effect in such a way that it makes perfect sense in the world of the movie. Because the film, whenever someone wears the mask, enters a strange world of unreality, the filmmakers can just constantly throw more and more 3D effects in, more than most any other 3D movie, without worry of seeming weird or silly or overdoing it. It's the whole point that you're there is to see crazy 3D stuff, and they do a great job of presenting it. It's all part of hell, you see. Even in the spoken prompt that tells audiences to put on their glasses, put the mask on now. It's not some voice that we are unable to identify, it's not a narrator, it's a character from the film. And he's telling the professor in a kind of eerie, ghostly way, like he's talking from the afterlife, to wear the mask. That's brilliant. It's a brilliant touch in how it all fits together. Like the mask was just made to slip over your face and transport you somewhere else. Nothing in it really takes you out of what's going on. I give The Mask 3 deadly, daring, delightful dimensions of film out of 5. Just like you've been yelling at your uncle who wears his Trump cape to Walmart, you're gonna be yelling at this movie.
Put the mask on now. Put the mask on now. Put the mask on now.
All of these things are designed to frighten a monkey.